Hey guys, thanks for coming in. Happy Monday and Happy New Year. Thank you for coming in tonight. Happy, thanks replay viewers. Lots of happy going around, so. And thanks YouTube viewers for coming in as well. This will go up on YouTube at Penguin and Fish Movies, and it will also stay here on Facebook on the Penguin and Fish page. We are gonna finish this guy up tonight. I'm hoping we have no video issues tonight. I'm hoping we're good to go. So I'm gonna flip you around and we'll get started. Hey there, hi guys, happy Monday. Thanks for coming in. We are going to finish up block 44 of the Splendid Sampler tonight. Here we are. We were having a couple of little video difficulties the other day, so we didn't get all these done, but we did get the little spool appliques fused on. We just need to hold them down with some stitches, I think. So that's the plan for tonight. And Happy New Year, everyone. I didn't come in last night. I think one of my New Year's things is to be to only do this during the weekdays. Over the all these holidays, I ended up spending a lot more time with family than I was expecting. My husband and I were expecting to work. We have a lot on our plate right now, and we're thinking we are going to be working all through the holidays, but we bailed on that and hung out with family, and it was what the doctor ordered. We needed that, and I think I'm going to start just doing this on weekdays so I can spend more time with family on the weekends, and I think that's the new plan. I think I will still do some of the mini marathons that we've been doing on Saturdays, just because I still do need to get these Splendid Sampler blocks together, but I think in general, yeah, I haven't 100% decided, but I think it's just going to be during the week now, this 9:30 p.m. Live stream here, so I don't know. Haven't made all my 2017 decisions yet, but I think that's the plan. I'd love to hear what you guys are doing for your 2017 plans and goals and all that. That I'm kind of in the midst of that now, just planning what's next. What am I doing? That's been my last few days, so we're getting it together. But right now, we are going to finish this block 44. Didn't finish as many blocks as I thought I would over the holidays. Like I said, we just hung out with family instead, which was probably a good move. But we're finishing it today. So I'm going to flip you guys around and we'll get started. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every night, probably now just weekday nights at 9:30 p.m. Central. And I love talking to you guys every night, and thanks so much for coming in. Yeah, back to working on the Splendid Sampler over the weekend. Nice, Donna. That's my plan, too. I'm just getting back into things now. So, all right, I'm going to flip you around, and we'll get started. Okay, here is the work area. So, tonight, I had all my intentions were to go on the machine and machine stitch around my applique pieces, but I think I'm bailing on that. I think I'm going to take my sparkly floss and do just like a tiny running stitch all around the three shapes. I think, you know, some of these shapes, especially this one, really blends into the background. I think it almost needs a little outline. So I thought some sparkly floss, a little running stitch, and we do the job. So my plan is to do the two strands of floss again, do the little running stitch around, and then right when I'm done with the running stitch to do the stitches across to make it look like I have, you know, like there's thread on these spools. So I think we'll just go to all three. This one I won't do the threads around, but I will still do the running stitch, stitching around. So the first and the third one, I think I'm gonna do with the white floss, the white sparkle. The only other place the white is this flower and the two stars. And I thought this middle one, I'd maybe do this gold. I thought it could be kind of pretty. So that is the plan tonight. Some embroidery. I'm excited to get going on that. I don't know, this, over the holidays, I've been really into embroidery lately. I must, I don't know, feel like I haven't done it in a while or something with the Splendid Sampler, but I've just been itching to do just tons of embroidery. So it's fun that we got that block 88 block done with all the embroidery, and we'll finish this embroidery, but we have that like hand embroidery yet. I'm kind of itching to get back to that guy. Block, what is that, block like 87 or something, 86, something like that. And soon we'll be getting our new embroidered blocks, not just embroidered blocks, but our new Splendid Sampler blocks. I think we're going to pick up again. What is it? Did they have it on the website, on the splendidsampler.com? I think it was like the 8th or something. We're going to start up again. And that'll be here in no time. All right, I'm going to weave. I hope I got enough here. I have just like, I don't know, maybe 18 inches or so, 24 inches. I'm going to weave it into the back here just so I continue my no-knot deal. Finished paper piecing the one. Oh, with the four bows. So cute. Yeah, I only have one section of that done. I'm definitely going to have to do a whole paper pieced day or something. I don't know. I have a lot of paper piecing to do yet on a ton of my blocks. But I'm kind of excited about that bow one. Kind of, you know, with the paper piecing, I'm a little nervous. I'm running out of some of my fabrics. I'll have to get back on all the paper piecing ones just to make sure I have enough to finish it all. You only worked on one embroidery block over the break. That's awesome that you gotta work on stuff yet, though. Yeah, I mean, we worked on this guy a little bit more, and block 88, which was that recent one with the piece, what was it? Love, Joy on it. I thought that one was pretty cute. And the two birds. I know, I'm going to have to go back to Mom's stash. Oh, she'd be mad at me. If I run out of all my fabrics, I'm going to have to steal more from her. All right, so we are ready to stitch this first little blue one. I'm not using the hoop anymore. I'm kind of using my hands as the hoop, so I have my two fingers here holding it, and then I'm kind of at the back too. I'm holding it taut, almost as if it's its own little hoop. It's not the most comfortable thing to do. A hoop is preferred, but you know, we just have these little pieces left, little applique pieces. I thought I could just stitch them down. All right, so a little running stitch. So typically, oh my gosh, you're all caught up and made the bonus blocks with the candles. Wow, Libby, that's awesome. Man, that's just like a little mini dream to be actually caught up. I don't know if I'm going to get there. Eventually, I'll have to get caught up, though, I would think. But typically, a blanket stitch is used. Oh, man, I'm going to have trouble here, I think. A blanket stitch is used to go around, like, as a little edging for applique like this, but I thought just a little, I'm going to go in and out, try that way of doing it. I thought a running stitch would be kind of cute. A blanket stitch, I think, just would have been too overpowering for these little itty-bitty appliques as an outline, at least for mine. So, I don't know. This little running stitch will imply that there's an edge around here, I think, because I'm thinking a lot of these blues get lost in the background color, the blue from the spools. Man, I should have maybe rethought this, though, a little bit. This floss, the metallic floss, can be so unruly, but we'll get there. We'll get into the rhythm of this, and then it'll feel better. I think just my threads are a little bit different length, so let's try and even that out. The trick with this metallic floss is that it's a little bit stretchy, so it acts kind of funny. So I'm just going to try and get these strands the same length. Yeah. See, one's a little bit more. But here, we can start to see, you know, we're already getting like a tiny little bit of a border, which I think is nice. Just trying to make little stitches here. I'm going in and out instead of all the way to the back, just because I'm thinking I can control the thread a little bit more, but clearly it's being kind of crazy, so maybe not. Luckily these pieces are pretty small, so we won't have to deal with it long. There we go, a little bit of a running stitch. So let me know what your guys' 2017 goals are. I am definitely, last year my, this, or yeah, 2016 was kind of, my word for the year was consistency, and I didn't get all of my consistent things down that I wanted to, but I did get a lot, and I want to continue on that this year and do just, like, healthy things like drink enough water and exercise, all those boring things that everyone says they want to do. But I think with, you know, consistency being last year, I think that's kind of a good next thing to try and be consistent on those things. Done any other sewing besides the sampler? I have not in a while done any other sewing, you know, and I have projects to do, but I'm trying to finish this one before getting too far ahead on other projects. Like, I have my jean quilt to finish yet, and, you know, there's always new ideas to do. But nope, I'm trying to keep it to the splendid sampler. One more stitch here to do. There we go. You need to be more equal with your hobbies and time. Mm-hmm. New obsession with quilting has made scrapbooking take a backseat. Yeah, sometimes, someone had said to think about things as seasons a little bit, so it might just be the season for quilting instead of the season for scrapbooking. But yeah, so the other kind of word, I haven't decided on, like, my word for 2017, but the other word, this was mentioned by a friend. I have to look it up yet just to find the exact meaning of this word yet, so hopefully it's right, but it's Kaizen, which, ooh, walk, move, stretch more. Yep, I gotta do that too, Laverne. too much ketchup to make a list. But the word is Kaizen, and I guess it's a Japanese term that was used for, like, workers in the 90s or something. I don't know. I have to look it all up. But it's the act of, like, always improving. So if you're working on a task, if there's a task that you do often, how can you make it easier or smoother to do? Like, make it less work for you. And I want to apply that to, like, everything. To cooking, to exercise, to, you know, work stuff, all of it. I want to Kaizen my life a little bit. Be effective with less work, like figuring out better ways to do the things that you're already doing, like more efficient ways of doing it, and always being on the lookout for that. So that's kind of the other word I'm toying with. I have to look it up and everything yet. But that is my plan. But I definitely, like, the whole self-care thing and eating right and exercise and drinking water, all that has got to be top priority. I've done well with those things in the past, but just for a limited amount of time. And now with my consistency word of 2016, I think maybe I'll be better equipped to stick with it, but we'll see. I did exercise today, Donna, so the exercise thing I'm doing is like every other day, and then I'll do like some stretching or yoga or something on the off days. But I did do legs today. Still just a little bit, but I'm doing it still, and I can feel it a couple days later, and as long as I can still have that, then I think I'm doing okay. Building into it again. Thanks, Donna. I felt pretty good that I did it today. I think I'm kind of sticking with the 6:30 p.m. kind of workout. So far, that's working okay for me. I like the idea of doing it right away in the morning, but I can't deal with stuff like that in the morning. I just can't. It's enough for me that I got up in the morning, honestly. And the thing that gets me up is knowing that I'll have my little yummy cup of coffee and I'll get to read my book. And then after I do that, I feel like I've had my nice time, and then I can get on with my day. So I just haven't added exercise into that. But I always get a little tired at 6:30, and there's still a little bit of time before I have to set up for this and eat food and all that. So 6:30 so far has worked pretty well for me. It's just a matter of not scheduling anything on top of it, but I don't do anything. I'm always here at home, so I don't really have a problem with that 6:30. So, all right, we have our little running stitch. I think, look at guys. I stitched in some of my back here. This is why I should have used a hoop. So, but you know what? I think I have enough space that I can just cut this and I'll be okay. getting back into things again, I guess. Making mistakes. Boo. So typically I would take this out, but I think... there. I just have a little extra back there. All right, but that's fine. I only have this little cut up here, so I'll be super fine still. You take something off. Monday is my light day. Oh, nice. Pilates and with your trainer. See, that's something I'd love to do yet. I know, I don't do that very often. That was kind of unexpected, but oh well, there's a little bonus fabric piece on the back. Ah, well. So, but I think it's looking cute with the stitching around. I did kind of bunch it up here a little bit, but whatever, that's fine too. I'm going to just deal with it. So now I'm going to just kind of satin stitch across here. So I'm just going to go, oh, look how fun it is, sparkly. I'm just going to do a bunch of stitches down the edge here. I want to still maybe see the little bits of fabric in between. Yes, 75% done. You know what? I wonder if I do have a hoop sitting around here. I might try and throw this in a hoop, but I'm not sure if I have one with the reach. Okay, there we go. This is just being a little too annoying. I think I am going to throw it in a hoop. I think my hoop's just big enough to fit everything in. There, this will solve some of our problems, I'm thinking. This is why it's easier to work in a hoop. First of all, it keeps everything taut, and I can use my hands on the back to feel what the heck I'm doing, which is much nicer. And I probably won't have all this bunching either anymore, because I'll have it in the hoop nicely. Ah, well, probably should have done that earlier. But I think we're still going to be just fine. All right, now let's continue. I was thinking maybe I wouldn't have enough fabric around for the hoop anymore, but oh man, this is already way easier. All right, so the nice thing is I can feel it on the back of I can feel the backs of the stitches while I'm working, and that's always nice. And caught on my ring though. Yeah, I think I was just proving a point to you. Yeah, that everyone does that once in a while, stitches in there. Oh, the worst is when you're doing like a binding for a quilt or something. Or no, not the binding, but when you're doing the quilting of the quilt and then you accidentally stitch in the part of the back fabric, like flips over and you've stitched some of that into the quilting, that blows. That's not fun when that happens. I was considering doing like zigzag stitches, you know, kind of like how a real spool of thread is, but I thought this straight across stuff would look a little bit more traditional, maybe. I think I'm going to throw one more up here. I don't like that little gap. I think the running stitch is nice. It's a little goofy, that little running stitch, but I do like that it kind of frames the bobbin, or the spool, I guess. Not the bobbin. I think it's a little extra touch. There, this is looking cute though, I think. All the little threads on there. Just get one more in there. Ooh, and we have just enough thread to, I might trim, there's a little, you know, part of the raw edge is coming up, which is going to happen eventually with these raw edges, but I might trim that little bit off there. But, all right, I think that is spool number one. Yeah, I think definitely with that border, that running stitch border and all the, you know, stitches here, I definitely think it's kind of brought into this motif a little bit more. It feels part of it, where these feel like maybe a little dark, and towards the back, this feels integrated a little bit more. So I think that'll be good to continue with those. So I'm just gonna weave in my ends here over this little tiny piece of fabric that got stuck in there. At least I got lucky that it was just the little edge here, and you know, we're gonna be trimming these down. It's not really working, I'm gonna go up this way. We're going to be trimming these down to the 6.5 inches, so I won't have to worry that I clip that little piece out, but well. It's almost like I had a vacation and I'm coming back and don't know what I'm doing anymore. All right, there we go. I feel like sometimes I need a recovery day from vacations a little bit. Like on New Year's Eve, my husband and I just didn't do anything. We played video games, which we never do. We do it like maybe once a year, and it was just fun. And so a whole pile of nothing. And then the next day, when I was all like amped up to get back to work, and then I just couldn't do anything that day either, which was yesterday, New Year's Day, the first. And so we ended up just doing nothing that day too. So I kind of had two vacation days instead of one. You plan to eat out less. That's what yes, during the week at lunchtime, walk more and take better care of yourself, relax more, go for a massage, time to read and quilt. Maureen, we are speaking the same language. That's exactly it. For me to just, you know, generally taking care of myself better, which this is where this Kaizen thing comes in. If I'm spending more time, you know, exercising and preparing food better and all that, if I'm taking time to do that, then I can't work as much, right? Or I can't work as much on other things that were, you know, things I was spending all my time on. So that forces me to prioritize more and do the things I'm doing now more efficiently. And, so that's kind of where that comes in. But yeah, that is totally what needs to happen this year for me. And I think, you know, I wanted to be last year consistent with a lot of things. Because I start things and then I quit like after a month, and I wanted to stop that. I felt like maybe this was just more of a habit that I was doing that maybe I could break somehow. And I think I was able to stick with two things. Oh, what you're trying to do. Yeah, Maureen, I'm going to look it up too. I haven't actually looked up the definition for sure. So I need to double check on it. But yeah, I felt like I've been consistent. I was able to stay consistent with my waking up in the morning and reading my book, which is a huge change. Like, I would always wake up right before I needed to and be super tired and barely get to work sort of thing. But now I'm waking up earlier and spending that little bit of time for myself, and that's been just, like, the best. And then the other consistent thing I've been doing is this. I think it's K-A-I-Z-E-N, Wanda, but I'm not positive. I'm going to have to look it up. But I think it's K-A-I-Z-E-N. Not positive. So I'm hoping, one thing that I wasn't as consistent with, I started out very consistent with it, but I want to get my consistency up on it this year, is the writing more. So I want to get more emails out and blog posts and all that. I really enjoy that writing, and I really enjoy talking to you guys through that medium and stuff too, through emails. Just you know, I love writing about stuff and then getting your emails, your responses on topics and stuff. I miss that. We had some things come up in the middle of the year, and that kind of was the thing that went out the window for me. So if you haven't gotten an email from me in a while, I'm hoping to get those up and running again. So that's a consistency thing that I want to continue. And this exercise, food, water, you know, taking care of myself thing. So those are my new consistencies I wanna work on for this year. So I'm kind of continuing the consistency, but it's morphing the consistency word. It's morphing into consistency specific to, like, my health and making my life easier. That's the Kaizen stuff. So I don't know. That's what's been on my mind the past couple days. All right, let's pull this needle through. I'm doing gold for the gold thread for this spool. I think it'll be pretty cute. This gold and this blue together. Oops, got that stuck underneath the applique of the other one. But yeah, so right now I'm going through all the little tasks that I've put off over the holidays, hoping to get caught up on that, and then it's back to, you know, figuring out the consistency and the Kaizen of it all. If Kaizen isn't actually the word that I'm, you know, it isn't actually the definition that we've been talking about, I think I might use it anyway and pretend it's that definition. We'll see. All right, I think this gold is pretty. Stretching this fabric out again. I think this funny little running stitch, it's making it look more folksy, I guess, like more hands-on, which I think is kind of perfect for this design. Kaizen, Chinese and Japanese for continuous improvement. That's it. When used, oh, I missed part of that. Let's see if I can scroll down. Oh, I can. When used in the business sense and applied to the workspace, Kaizen refers to activities that continually improve all functions and involve all... Oh, I can't read the rest right now. Well, perfect. I'm missing the... I'm pre-diabetic and exercise, better diet. Yep, Marine, that's awesome. Paint your living room and foyer. Oh, fun. That took me 2 weeks. Oh gosh. Yeah, that's definitely a big job, doing all that home improvement and painting and stuff. We just did our living room a couple months ago. I think I showed you guys that we painted it, and I don't get it. Like, people love just painting the room. I'm just going to paint my room today, you know? Like, I don't get it. It's, like, to me, it's so much work. You got to move everything. You got to cover everything. It's, like, a huge ordeal in my brain. So to just, like, on a whim, I'm going to paint this room. I don't know. That sounds just so insane and stressful to me. That was the first room we painted since we moved into our house, like, I don't know, 9 years ago or however long we've been here. That was enough. Enough for me. I don't need to paint any other rooms. Yes, torture. Yeah. I don't know. And people just love doing it. Like, oh, let's just make the room red this year. And then spend all that time doing it. I don't know. I mean, I love the color that it is now. Like, I love that we did paint it. But geez, I don't know. We painted it for a time period. We didn't paint it to just paint over it again right away. Ugh. So I can understand how that would take a bunch of time and you wouldn't get all your, any crafting and stuff done for sure. But are you happy with it now? That's the important part. Yes, and Mickey downstairs. That was the other project that we kind of did last year, and it was, you know, barely a project. It doesn't even look like we did anything, but we scraped the wall in our basement, like a bunch of paint away on the wall. On the cinder block, painted directly onto the cinder block. So they painted the wrong paint on the cinder block, so it was chipping away and stuff. So we scraped off the paint that we could and revealed these, like, Mickey Mouse was, like, a big decal or a painted something of Mickey Mouse. And we also found Donald and Goofy. Not Goofy. What's the other dog? Pluto. Pluto downstairs, too. So, Gina, that's all we did. We ended up, we scraped the wall, we repaired it where it needed, but we didn't paint it or anything. We just put, like, shelves and stuff in front of it, so you can still see Mickey, and you can still see Donald and Pluto. Wait a sec. Yeah, Pluto. Pluto's the one that acts like a dog. Goofy's the one that's a dog that acts like a human. Pluto. So they're kind of partially revealed because not all the paint would scrape off, but, so it's, like, I couldn't paint over it. It was just too fun having those characters appear down there just randomly from whoever the homeowner was before us, and I don't know, it was just too silly. So we left it. We just put our, we have some work tables and some shelves that we put down there, and we just kind of put it in front of it, but we can still see them peeking through. So yeah, that was the other house project we did, and you know, it doesn't look like we did a dang thing, but we know we did a lot of work down there. But yeah, the downstairs has turned into a totally legit livable space. We have some desks down there, and we have a little couch down there, and where it was a space that just had bins of storage, now it's, like an actual place we can go down there and, like, be down there. That's very exciting. It's like a whole new area. All right, I'm just gonna do the running stitch around here just to make it look like these other two, and we're gonna be done. But I like this gold. I think the gold brings in some of these other colors again. Same with how the white did. So I need enough to go around this whole thing. That should be too much. It's a running stitch. Running stitches don't take up too much thread. It takes about the length of the thread to go around. I don't think I need a ton. I'm not going to go back and forth on this. But then we'll be done with this guy. I think maybe I need a little bit more. We'll just have to cut it out yet. Cut it into the 6.5 inches. I don't think I'm going to press it beforehand. I don't think I really need to. It'll be close enough without pressing. But you know what? Along with this whole, the metal. So, well, I'll talk about this in a little sec here, but, I forgot what I was going to say. Anyway, I found this ring in, I have this little ring case, and I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna wear it today. My brother gave me this a while ago. It's not in focus. Let's see. There we go. It has numbers on it, and you can actually, I want it to stay in focus here, but there. So you can actually move the numbers. So there it says one, so you can move it. And he got it for me. It's actually used for, like, gamers. So, like, if you play, like, a lot of board games and stuff, you can keep score. But I thought it would be great, first of all, for, like, for knitting, you could keep track of what row you're on just by, you know, or, like, what stitch you're on by moving the stitches. And the other thing I thought it'd be good for is I'm wearing it because it's going to be my my marker for if I drank enough water that day. So it's like my water reminder. Like, so today I drank pretty well I had a lot of water. So I feel like today is a day that I could mark like a big X on my water. So at the end of the day, I'm going to put it at one. So I'm going to see how many days in a row I can consistently drink enough water. So I started that today. I'm still at zero because I'm starting it today. I need to go the full day without, you know, without messing up. So at the end of the day, I can mark it. But I saw it again today, and I'm like, you know what? That's going to be my visual reminder. And, you know, just to, if you see the number getting bigger and bigger, that means, you know, I stuck with it. So that's kind of my plan with that. I can't quite remember the manufacturer, but if you looked up like game counter ring or something, I bet you'd find it. There's some that spin, like my brother has one that spins and then wherever, like a dice, wherever it stops, that's like, you know, where the dice landed kind of thing. This one, all the numbers stay in place with like a little spring. It has that little metal down the middle that holds it together like a spring. And then you can move it to cut, like, keep score or something. But I think for a stitch counter or, you know, a goal counter, that's what it's going to be for me. So I'm going to hopefully remember to keep wearing it. And remember to keep drinking water. See how many days in the, or not even just drinking water, but just like the whole consistently healthy thing, like the working out and the water and the sleeping and all that. So every day I can do that in a row, then I get to go up another day. But if I mess up, then I got to start over. I got to start my counter over. Yes, exactly, Carol. I'm the same way. So I need to like make a special effort to make sure that I'm doing enough of that stuff. And the thing is, I have to trick myself to do anything. Anything I do that's healthy is because I've tricked myself to do it. So this is another trick. It's a trick because it's a visual reminder, first of all. So whenever I look at it, I'm like, oh yeah, I gotta remember, I wanna do healthy stuff. But also if I can see the number go higher on it, then I'm like, ooh, I don't wanna break that, you know, streak of good stuff I've been doing. So it's, you know, I need that gaming aspect to it, I think, a little bit to stay healthy. So that's kind of my plan. I'm gonna go around the opposite direction, I think, with this for no reason. But yeah, it's kind of a fun ring. I really like it. And it's kind of like this purpley sort of you know, oil spill type look to it. A water bottle, just having a water bottle around. Yeah, I've been trying, you know, I've been doing a little bit better when I've been putting like, I've been trying to do like lemon water or tea. I've been kind of doing, I've been counting tea and all that as water too. I've been drinking a lot more tea lately. This could use a thimble when I go through this many stitches, but we'll see how we do here. I'm gonna set it on the ground. There we go. So more water, more tea. But yeah, I definitely feel like I'm drinking more when it's got like some lemon or lime or something in. That's my little crutch for now, I suppose.
Have you seen the new bottle that
lights up and keeps track of how many bottles on the lid? I have not. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. I have not seen that. Oh man, see, I need something like that. Some crazy device. Some crazy, unnecessary device to help me stay on track. I love it. Lights up and keeps track of how many bottles on the lid. Yeah. I feel like that's one of those things I might stick with for, like, 6 days and then not do it anymore. I don't know. That's kind of the weird thing. Some things I can stick with and some things I can't. And that's like this whole consistency thing that I'm trying to get better at. It lights up to remind you to drink if you haven't drank in 60 minutes. Oh, so now that's, I like that. The reminder aspect of it. Not so much the guilt aspect of it. Like, hey, you've only drank this much today. You're cracking. But yeah, that reminder, that's kind of nice. That I could see. I'll have to look it up. So many funny things out there. Fun gadgets. So on this bigger applique, I'm really kind of liking this running stitch. I think it looks a little bit more delicate than it does on these ones down here. Oh, you saw it advertised on Facebook? Funny. But yeah, I'm excited to get on my exercise routine again, and I think this 6:30 time to do it is going to work out for me, and I'm feeling good about it. Oops, this one's tough. So this one I'm going through a bunch of layers of fabric because we have the seam allowance for both of these. So let's see if I can get through one stitch. So festive with all this gold sparkles. Go down right here. It's a little tricky with these two strands of floss. This would have been a lot easier with one strand of floss, but the rest of it I've done with two, so I was just sticking with the two. Oh, your daughter bought you one of the light up water bottles. How do you like it, Laverne? Have you used it a lot yet? There we are. It's kind of tough going through all these layers. So I have, here I have the seam allowance, so that's a couple of extra layers. But other than that, I have the two layers of fabric, and then there's that, Wonder Under, the fusible web, that's what it's called. That's in the middle here, too. So this is actually kind of three layers of stuff that I'm going through, and then a bunch of stitches all at once. It makes it a little difficult to pull the needle through, but it's still easier to do a bunch of stitches at once, I think. Oh, it begins tomorrow. Nice. So you had that little extra vacation like I did too, like where you need a vacation from the vacation. Yeah, I feel like today was kind of like my first day where I felt like I was back at it a little bit. But again, I'm still kind of wrapping up loose ends from before the vacation, and I think I'll really be back on top of things, by the end of this week, I think. Then I can say that I'm in the groove again, I'm thinking. Because I'm hoping so. Getting things going slowly. Alright, I'm going through all those seam allowances again here. My threads are a little bit different length. There we go. But yeah, I'll probably have a little bit, another glass of tea when I'm done here. Jeez, I keep stabbing myself. And then, you know, I'm trying to go to bed at a normal time too, so we'll see if I can continue doing that. I pretty much found out that I need exactly 8 hours of sleep to function. Like, I'll turn the alarm clock off, like, subconsciously until it's been, like, the exact 8 hours. I'm trying to get to bed early enough that I can do that. Yeah, slow to get going, Laverne, after all the holidays. I mean, if you think about it, it's like Thanksgiving and, you know, Christmas and New Year's. It's just like a lot of time for the brain to be somewhere else, I guess. So it makes sense that there'd be a little bit of a, you know, get back into things period. So here is a bunch of the seam allowance again. I'm just going to go one stitch at a time, I think. And this is raw edge applique, so these edges will, you know, they're exposed, so they will get raw, like a raw frayed look after a while. But you know what? I think that's kind of cute, and I feel like it kind of goes with this design. A little bit. Alright, we are almost done here. Let's just do the straightaway here. I think this one's really cute with this little running stitch around on this bigger pieced one. I don't know, I'm pretty excited about this block. I wasn't sure if I would like all the applique with it, but now I think it's really dang cute. Alright, I just I think we'll just do one more stitch in here. Thought I could maybe get two in there, but I think it'll be more even with just one slightly bigger stitch. There we go. Just like that. Oh, thanks, Laverne! All right, let's weave in that end again and trim this down to 6.5 inches, and we got another black done. That's very exciting. So I do have my sewing machine out here. Maybe I'll just leave it out, and I don't know, maybe we should start on some paper piecing. I'm kind of way behind on paper piecing, but I don't know, I've been feeling the embroidery itch lately, so maybe we'll stick with embroidery. I don't know. We'll see how it goes tomorrow, and I'll make a decision tomorrow right before we come on here. But we'll definitely be working on another block tomorrow, because this guy will be done. All right, let's take it out of the hoop. Again, I don't think I'm going to iron it. My iron's not plugged in right now. I think it'll just kind of relax by itself. Ah, so cute. Let's cut it. So I'm going to just try and center it within my little square here. This ruler is 6.5 inches. Oh yeah, there's a hand block. I do want to do that one, Jennifer. That one will take a few days yet, but I don't know. I have been feeling the embroidery lately. That'd be kind of fun. So I'm taking kind of the farthest points here. So this is about 3/4 inch, and this one is just about now. So it's centered horizontally now, I think. Let's center it vertically. It's about another 3/4 inch. Yeah, so I think we're probably good right about here. I also want to visually center it. So the only thing that's way over here is the star. So it's heavy on this side. So I think I want to move it over though. The embroidery with the little tomatoes. Oh, I know what one you're talking about. The one that's like an X with the rows of stitching. No, I'm very much not done with that one. I have only one row, and then I've been doing all those tiny little, if that's what you're talking about, the tiny little red French knots that look like little cherry tomatoes. That one we could break out again too. Yep, I got a lot of embroidery yet, that's for sure. A lot of embroidery. There's a lot of embroidery, a lot of paper piecing, and a lot of applique left to do. Oh, you just finished your first embroidery block and you haven't embroidered in 40 years. How fun, Jennifer, that is awesome. I hope you had fun with it and you want to keep going. It's definitely, if you've been quilting for a while, I think I'm going to try and do this without turning it. It's definitely a change of pace, but I feel like with the Splendid Sampler, we've gotta have that opportunity, I guess. Like with all the different techniques that we're using, we've had the opportunity to try different paced things, like, you know, things that you do have to take a few weeks to do. Oh, that's cool, Jennifer. That's so good to hear. But yeah, so some take a few weeks, some we can get done in one block or one session. I think I have a little funny edge here. Let's just like square that up again. And I think if I ironed it, it'd probably be a hair better, but I'm gonna just leave it. So there we are, another finished block. I think this one turned out so cute. I love the sparkly floss. I think it was probably a good idea to define these edges a little bit, because I think, especially this guy, I think it would have just looked weird with just some thread going across. I don't think you would have been able to see these edges. So I think that helped a little bit. I like it. It was fun to try stitching on a dark color like this, and I like the sparkle floss. I'm calling it done. Two thumbs up. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna flip you around and we'll take a look at it over here. Hello again! It's so nice to finish a block. So, here we are. It's so sparkly, like, it really is catching the light. I think it'll just kind of pop a little bit on the quilt, which is kind of fun. I'm excited. I will totally stitch with that thread some more. I was kind of testing it. I haven't done a full embroidery really with it that's this big. So that was fun. I'm digging it, liking the floss. It is kind of weird to work with, but not totally unruly. It's just, you know, slightly more than the 6-strand embroidery floss. It was fun though. Okay, this will go up on YouTube. I know I'm very far behind. I think it's my last one up there is December 10th. That's one of my things on the list to catch up with in this next week. So I will get that up and I'll get this video up on there as well. And then it'll stay here on Penguin and Fish. So if you're on Facebook, just do a search for Penguin ampersand Fish and you'll get to my page and all these videos should be there as well. So thanks again, guys. It's great to be back and I will see you tomorrow. Have a great start of your New Year's and wish everyone the best. So have a great night, guys. See you tomorrow.